Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you lens antenna. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of lens antenna. After that, I'll explain you working principle of lens antenna. After that, I'll explain you two different types of lens antenna. After that, I'll explain you concept of zoned lens antenna, and at last I'll sum up this session with advantages, limitations and applications of lens antenna. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of lens antenna. Lens antenna is having two elements. One is feed antenna and second is lens. If you observe here with lens antenna structure, we have feed antenna over here. This feed antenna is active element. Active element means with this feed we will be providing supply, while this lens, that is parasitic element. Why it is parasitic element? The reason is this lens is not connected with feed. See, job of this lens is to convert spherical wavefront into planar wavefront. Let me explain you how. See, this feed antenna that will be radiating EM waves, and it will be having spherical wavefront, you can observe. And this spherical wavefronts, that is converted into planar wavefront by lens antenna. See, spherical wavefront that cannot travel to longer distance, planar wavefront can travel to long distance. Here, this lens antenna that is converting spherical wavefront into planar wavefront, right? This lens antenna that is having one advantage over reflector antenna, that lens antenna has no blockage issues. In my last video, I have explained reflector antenna. With reflector antenna, we have seen there is an issue of blockage. The reason is, as and when you transmit EM waves, at that time, feed comes in between the path of transmission. If you have seen my explanation on reflector antenna, then in that I have explained, as and when you transmit EM waves with the use of feed, at that time, whatever waves, those are there along the axis of parabola, those are again coming back to feed over here, because of which there is an issue of blockage. That issue is not there with lens antenna, right? So with lens antenna, we have one advantage over reflector antenna, that it does not have any issue of blockage, right? Otherwise, lens antenna and reflector antenna both are used to convert spherical wavefronts into planar wavefront. Now, I'll be explaining you working principle of lens antenna. Lens antenna can be used as a transmitter as well as it can be used as a receiver. As if you use lens antenna as a transmitter, at that time, lens antenna will be converting spherical wavefront into planar wavefront. Like you can observe, here we have transmitter lens, in which this feed antenna that is transmitting EM waves, that is having spherical wavefront over here. These spherical wavefronts are converted into planar wavefront using this lens over here, as if you use this lens antenna as a transmitter lens. And this lens antenna that one can use as a receiver antenna as well. See, as in when you use lens antenna as a receiver antenna, at that time, whatever EM waves that is coming to lens antenna, those are planar in wavefront. If you observe here, planar wavefront that is coming to antenna over here, and this planar wavefront that is converted into spherical wavefront over here with the use of this lens antenna, and those waves are getting converged and focused at feed over here. See, as and when you use this lens antenna as a receiver antenna, at that time you don't need to have higher area with aperture of this feed. The reason is all the waves are getting converged at the focal point, right? So here, see, all of these waves that is getting converged at this focal point, that's why you don't need to have higher aperture area with this feed antenna, right? So in case of receiver lens, this lens antenna will be converting planar wavefront into spherical wavefront. Here, one more interesting thing that you need to understand. See, this lens is improving directivity of antenna. If you talk about this feed antenna, then with this feed antenna, if you observe the radiation pattern, then it will be looking somewhat like this, where this is major lobe and here we have minor lobes, right? But after using lens, its directivity will improve. After lens, if you observe the radiation pattern, then major lobe will be having very narrow beam width and smaller minor lobes will be there, right? So this lens antenna that is improving directivity of given antenna. So lens antenna is converting spherical wavefront into planar wavefront, by which it is having very narrow beam width and that is resulting into higher directivity of antenna. Now I'll explain you types of lens antenna. There are two types of lens available in the market. First one is conducting type and second one is dielectric type. Both of these lens are used to convert spherical wavefronts into planar wavefront. Let me explain you how. See, with dielectric type lens, at middle we have higher width, while on edges we have lower width. While with conducting type, at middle we have lower width and on edges we have higher width. And both of these lens are converting spherical wavefronts into planar wavefronts. Let me explain you how. See, with dielectric type, if you talk about velocity inside material, if I say if it is V dash and in free space if it is V, then inside material V dash is lower than free space velocity. If you observe path length of wave over here at middle, that is less, but here material is more, because of which it will take more time to arrive over here. While on edge, path length is more over here, but here material is less. That's why it will take less time over here. And in total, all the waves will be arriving parallelly over here, which is resulting into planar wavefront. While in conducting type, if I say here inside material velocity is V dash and in free space velocity is V, then V dash will be greater than V. So inside material velocity is higher over here. And as velocity is higher inside material, on edges we have larger thickness of material, because of which this spherical wavefront that is getting converted into planar wavefront, the reason is at middle we have short path length and on edges we have higher path length. But on edges velocity is high, that's why this spherical wavefront is getting converted into planar wavefront, right? So both of these types of lens are available in the market, but one should know with conducting type, width of material is less in the middle, while with dielectric type, width of material is more in the middle. That is how things are there. Now I'll explain you zoned concept with lens antenna. Lens antenna structure is very heavy. It is bulky in nature. The reason is whatever lens that we are using, that is completely filled with material. If you observe the lens over here, then that is completely filled with material, because of which it is bulky in nature. If you have bulky antenna, then one cannot use that bulky antenna in satellite applications. The reason is on satellite, cost of weight is too high. So to reduce cost of weight, we can provide zoned concept in which we can cut the material. Let me explain you how. You can observe here, see, we have cut the material, right? So now this much material is only available and this much material is having, but obviously lower weight compared to complete lens, right? So if you want to reduce weight of lens, then one can use zoned lens in which we are cutting the section of material. One more way is there. See, at middle, you can use higher dielectric constant. If I say if it is epsilon R1 and over here, whatever dielectric constant is there, if I say that is epsilon R2, and if I say epsilon R1 is greater than epsilon R2, by which also one can reduce overall weight of lens antenna, right? But in zoned concept, what we do is we cut the material over here to lower down the weight of lens. So that is how zoned concept is there. Now I'll explain you advantages, disadvantages and applications of lens antenna. Lens antenna is having major advantage of no blockage. As I have explained in reflector antenna, we have been having issues of blockage. That issue is not there with lens antenna. So there is no blockage, because of which lens antenna receives more EM waves compared to reflector antenna. Lens antenna is also used for low noise application, as well as it is having higher gain. The reason is lens antenna converts spherical wavefronts into planar wavefront. If you talk about limitations, then one should know lens antenna is heavy in nature and it is complex to construct, and as it is having heavy weight, it is costlier antenna. If you talk about applications, then lens antenna is used for long range applications like satellite applications, like deep space applications. Those are the applications which is there with directive antenna. Lens antenna is highly directive antenna, so one can use it for long range applications, as well as we can use lens antenna for microwave transmission. So that is how lens antenna is there with us. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Still, if anything that I would like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.